Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Safriya Palace Abdullah bin Hassan Ahmed Al Buhainin and Masuma Abdul Rasul Isa, where they were sworn in before His Majesty the King on the occasion of appointing them as President of the Court of Cassation, Deputy President of the Supreme Judicial Council, the SJC, and Agent of the Court of Cassation, respectively, by a royal order. His Majesty also received the President of the Legislation and Legal Opinion Commission, the LLOC, Nawaf Abdullah Hamza, and Deputy President of LLOC, Muhammad Ahmed Ali Mugbil, where they expressed appreciation and gratitude to His Majesty for his trust, affirming that they will do their best to carry out their duty and serve the country and its people. His Majesty affirmed his keenness on reinforcing the independence of the judiciary, supporting the judicial authority, and providing qualified cadres for the important role of protecting laws and enhancing the security and stability of the community, asserting that working under the principle of justice and equality is a cornerstone of building a modern state. His Majesty congratulated the guests, praising their expertise and competence in the legislative and judicial fields, wishing them success in carrying out their national duty. His Majesty hailed the efforts of the SJC members in their positions, commending the continuous organization and development of Bahraini judiciary in its structure and legislation. He stated that Bahrain is keen on developing its various institutions and providing it with cadres and national competencies, affirming that the national development continues as a result of the solidarity of the three authorities, lauding the efforts of the people of Bahrain to develop their country. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received today at Safriya Palace the Sheikh of Bani Khalid tribe, Sheikh Khalid bin Naif Al Ara'ir, accompanied by Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Zahrani and Sheikh Khalid's sons, Muhammad and Al Walid bin Khalid bin Naif Al Ara'ir, who greeted His Majesty on the occasion of their visit to Bahrain. His Majesty welcomed the guests, commending the historic brotherly relations between Bahrain and Saudi Arabia and their continuous development. His Majesty wished Sheikh Khalid bin Naif Al Ara'ir and his sons success and prosperity and a pleasant stay in Bahrain. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa received today at Ghudaybiyya Palace Prince Michael of Kent. His Royal Highness hailed the status of the Bahraini-UK ties, the solidarity of bilateral cooperation, and the two countries' keenness on developing it in joint interest fields, including military and defense, to achieve the ambitious and aspirations of the two countries. He affirmed the importance of enhancing cooperation in the context of continuous communication and joint coordination between Bahrain and the United Kingdom. The Prime Minister reviewed the historic bilateral relations, asserting Bahrain's keenness on solidifying strategic relations, highlighting the regional and international role of the UK in serving security, peace, and stability. For his part, Prince Michael of Kent commended the outstanding Bahraini-UK relations and the two countries' efforts to develop them in various fields. We'll be right back. Commander-in-Chief of the Bahrain Defense Force, BDF, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, received today Prince Michael of Kent in the presence of Defense Affairs Minister Lieutenant General Yusuf bin Ahmed Al Jalahma and the Chief of Staff of the Bahrain Defense Force, the BDF, Lieutenant General Ziyab bin Sagr Al Naimi. During the meeting, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa welcomed the Prince and commended the historic friendly relations between the two countries, noting the development relations are witnessing in various fields, especially in military and defense cooperation to serve the interests of both countries and their people. Also present were Director of the BDF General Command's Court, Major General Hassan Mohammed Saad, Inspector General Major General Abdullah Hassan Naimi, Assistant Chief of Staff for Supply and Catering, Rear Admiral Yusuf Ahmed Malallah, Director of Military Cooperation, Rear Admiral Mohammed Abdullah Sada, and the Royal Bahrain Naval Force, the RBNF Commander, Rear Admiral Sheikh Khalifa bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa deputized the Minister of Defense Affairs, Lieutenant General Yusuf bin Ahmed Al Jalahna, to attend the 9th graduation ceremony of the Staff and Command at the Royal College of Command, Staff and National Defense, which was held under His Majesty's patronage. The Chief of Staff of Bahrain Defense Force, the BDF, Lieutenant General Ziyab bin Sagr Al Naimi, delivered a speech on this occasion.
سيدي سعادة الفريق الركن يوسف بن أحمد الجلاهمة وزير شؤون الدفاع أصحاب السعادة ضيوفنا الكرام إخواني الضباط السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته إنه لمن دواعي السرور أن نرى في هذا اليوم المبارك ثمرة من ثمار الكلية الملكية للقيادة والأركان والدفاع الوطني والحمد لله الذي من بتوفيقه على من اجتازوا بنجاح دورة القيادة والأركان المشتركة التاسعة ويسعدنا أن نبارك لهم جميعاً ويشرفني أن أنقل لكم تحيات سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه وتحيات سيدي صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله وتحيات سيدي صاحب المعالي المشير الركن خليفة بن أحمد آل خليفة القائد العام لقوة دفاع البحرين حفظه الله كما يسرني أن الترحيب بأشقائنا الأعزاء من القوات المسلحة بالدول الشقيقة الذين شاركوا إخوانهم هذه الدورة وتبادلوا معهم الخبرات والمعرفة ومما لا شك فيه أن كليات القيادة والأركان والدفاع الوطني تمثل رافداً حيوياً يدعم خطط تطوير القوات المسلحة ولله الحمد قد نجحت كليات القيادة والأركان مجلس التعاون في مسايرة نظيراتها على المستوى العالمي وعملت بكفاءة ومقدرة عاليتين على تأهيل الكوادر الوطنية بالقدر المنشود من العلوم العسكرية المتخصصة والدراسات التعبوية العليا ذات القيمة العلمية المتقدمة إن بناء وطن عصري قوي ونقله إلى مصاف أحدث الدول يعتمد في الأساس على الكفاءات الوطنية المتسلحة بالعلم والمعرفة والإيمان بوطنها والولاء لقيادته وبرسالته الوطنية والانتماء إلى مبادئ ديننا الإسلامي الحنيف وروابط مجتمعنا الخليجي المشترك وتقاليد عروبتنا الأصيلة وأن نعي وندرك أن ما نحققه للوطن من عمل وبذل وصدق انتماء فإننا بذلك نحقق لأنفسنا العزة والكرامة والتقدم والازدهار فعليكم مواصلة اعتماد سلاح العلم والمعرفة للارتقاء بقدراتكم كغارة للمستقبل لتتحملون مسؤوليتكم الوطنية في الدفاع عن الوطن والمشاركة في عملية التنمية والتطوير في خضم التحديات والمخاطر والمؤامرات ومشاريع الفتن ومخططات التخريب للقوى الطائفية المحيطة بنا ينبغي علينا أن نعد لذلك عدته كما أمرنا الله تعالى بقوله وأعدوا لهم ما استطعتم من قوة ويجب علينا أن نتعاضد ونتكاتف كما حثنا الله تعالى بقوله واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا وانطلاقا من تلك المبادئ الربانية علينا السير بوتيرة أسرع وأمتن لاستحضار المواقف الأخوية الحازمة للتصدي لتلك التهديدات والابتعاد عن المواقف التي تقف ضد حركة تاريخنا الأخوي وتسيء إليه وتؤجج الفتنة التي تولد الإرهاب وتزعزع الأمن والاستقرار وتؤثر على فاعلية دورنا في مواجهة التهديدات التي تتربص بالأمن القومي العربي. علينا توحيد جهودنا والقيام بمسؤولياتنا والمضي على العهد بمواصلة أدوارنا الوطنية الجسام التي تؤديها قواتنا المسلحة في دول مجلس التعاون، والسير على طريق الأخوة بتقوية جسور التعاضد العسكري لدعم عمليات عاصفة الحزم وإعادة الأمل بقيادة الشقيقة الكبرى المملكة العربية السعودية، دعماً للشرعية بالجمهورية اليمنية الشقيقة وضماناً للسلم والأمن الدوليين. ومن أجل أن يكون لمجلس التعاون دور تاريخي في دعم قضايا أمتنا العربية والإسلامية ونصرة الحق. وختاماً، يسعدنا أن نشكر آمر الكلية وهيئة التدريس وجميع المعلمين على إخلاصهم وعملهم الجاد المثمر الذي حقق هذا الإنجاز، والذي نعتز به جميعاً مع أمنياتنا الصادقة بدوام التوفيق والنجاح لكل رجال القوات المسلحة بدول مجلس التعاون دول الخليج العربية والدول العربية الشقيقة، والنصر والثبات لإخواننا المشاركين في عملية عاصفة الحزم وإعادة الأمل، سائلين المولى سبحانه وتعالى لكم دوام النجاح ومستقبلا زاهرا لما فيه خير وطننا جميعا.
بعدها ألقى اللواء الركن بحري عبد الله سعيد.
The Commandant of the Royal Command Staff and National Defense College, Rear Admiral Abdullah Saeed Al-Mansouri, delivered a speech. After that, an officer delivered a speech on behalf of his fellow graduates, followed by a speech by graduate officers from brotherly countries. Then a poem was recited following the speeches.
مع دارنا دار السلام، الكتاب وسنة المصطفى نمشي بها، الأخوة بيننا والوفا والاحترام، شجرة خضراء على السحاب بشعيبها، صف واحد كلنا ما يجي بيننا انقسام، العهود وجيهنا بيض ما نصخيبها، ولي العهد سلمان لك مثل الحسام، العلوم الطيبة كلها يحريبها، وخليفة لابدا لازمه شد الحزام، المشير اللي ذا قام حل صعيبها، قايد جيش مسلح على أمره بالمهام، محتسينه حزة يقترب حريبها، لو عد طيبكم طال شعري والكلام، والقصيدة ينتهي الحفل ما يمديبها. ابتدينا وانتهينا لنا تقريب عام، وانتهلنا من علوم السعد ونجيبها، بين تدريب وتعليم باسلوب والنظام، من قداوات سبق قبلنا تدريبها، وزملانا نور يجلي سراميد الظلام، كل يمثل بلاده سما يسمي بها، وانا مثل في مقامي رفيعين المقام، السعود اخوان نوره وانا ماريبها، وانا مثل في مقامي رفيعين المقام، السعود اخوان نوره وانا ماريبها، حبهم يجري في دمي ومخ العظام، الولا متوارثينه شباب وشيبها، تحت راية سيدي ننطح الهيج شمام، دام نفسي تحمل الروح لضحي بها، والختام ازكى تحية وتقدير وسلام، مملكة البحرين ما هو غريب نطيبها، وسلامتكم.
The Minister of Defense Affairs handed out certificates to graduates from the Kingdom of Bahrain, the United Arab Emirates, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Oman, Kuwait, Hashemite Kingdom of Jordan, Egypt, and the Republic of Yemen. He congratulated them and wished them success in serving their homelands.
Thank you.
The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Khalifa, participated in the meeting of Ministers of Foreign Affairs of the Kingdom of Bahrain, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, and the Republic of Egypt, alongside the U.S. Secretary of State Rex Tillerson, which was held today in Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. The meeting was attended by Kuwait's Minister of Cabinet Affairs and Acting Minister of Information, Sheikh Mohammed Al Abdullah Al Mubarak Al Sabah. The meeting discussed views and coordination on the latest developments regarding the severance of relations with the state of Qatar and ways to eliminate terrorism and all those who support or fund it. The ministers of foreign affairs expressed appreciation for the sincere efforts exerted by the Emir of Kuwait, His Highness Sheikh Sabah Al Ahmed Al Jaber Al Sabah, to maintain the security and stability of the region. They also valued the United States' pivotal role in this regard as the strategic ally for the countries of the region. The ministers affirmed the continued continuity of joint coordination regarding regional issues, mainly the war against terrorism, stressing the need to intensify the efforts to eliminate this phenomenon and drying up its funding sources. The Kingdom of Bahrain, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Egypt, and the United Arab Emirates issued a joint statement yesterday, hailing the efforts of the United States to combat terrorism and its financing embodied in the Islamic American Summit, which represented a stern international stance against terrorism. The statement noted the signing of the MOU between the United States and Qatari authorities is a result of the constant demands of the four countries and their allies over the past years to stop supporting terrorism. The four countries stressed that they will closely monitor the seriousness of the Qatari authorities to combat terrorism and its financing. The four countries also affirmed that the measures taken were a result of the Qatari authorities' support to terrorism, embrace of extremism, spread of hatred rhetoric, and interference in the internal affairs of other countries. They added that these activities must stop immediately to implement the four countries' legitimate demands. The statement stressed that the Qatari authorities have constantly revoked all agreements and commitments, the most recent of which was the Riyadh Agreement in 2013, which led to the withdrawal of ambassadors and their return only after signing of the supplementary agreement by the Qatari authorities in 2014. Qatar continues to intervene in other countries' internal affairs, conspire against countries, embrace terrorists, fund terrorist operations, spread rhetoric of hatred and extremism, which make any obligation by Qatar according to its existing policy difficult to trust without the establishment of strict controls to verify its seriousness of returning to the right track. The four countries affirmed the continuity of all current measures taken by them until the Qatari authorities commit to implementing all of the fair demands, which guarantee countering terrorism and maintaining the region's security and stability. The custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, received today the U.S. Secretary of State, Rex Tillerson. Tillerson conveyed greetings from the U.S. President Donald Trump to King Salman. The Saudi monarch reviewed with the U.S. Secretary of State Saudi-U.S. relations, as well as the latest regional developments, especially counterterrorism efforts. Tillerson's trip from Kuwait to the western Saudi city of Jeddah follows talks the previous day with the Qatari rulers. He previously held discussions with the Emir of Kuwait, who is mediating the dispute. Saudi Arabia, the UAE, Egypt, and Bahrain severed relations with Qatar and cut air, sea, and land routes with it after Qatar was found to be supporting extremist groups.
A very good evening. You're watching the Business News in Bahrain International with me, Hiba Abdul Ghaffour. Bahrain Oil Share Index closed today at 1,317.14 points, marking an increase of 7.92 points before the previous closing. The increase was due to the rise in the commercial banks, industrial services and investment sectors, and investors mainly traded in the industrial sector, representing 65% of the total value of traded shares. 76 equity transactions took place with a volume of 1,781,765, worth 482,901 Bahraini dinars.